Well, this is going to be an exciting holiday cooking segment. Oh, I've got a special guest joining me a little bit later on. That'll be Philomena with her cranberry salsa. But I was thinking, what is more iconic for the holidays than chestnuts roasting over an open fire? So we're gonna start with two chestnut recipes. I'm gonna make chestnut cookies and I'm going to make chestnut hummus. And it's really very easy. I mean, chestnuts are so moist and flavorful and they have that nutty sweetness. The biggest pain is roasting them. You know, you gotta cut the eggs in the shell, bake them, and then peel them and make sure that you don't leave the skin on because that can be bitter. For this recipe, you'll need 1 pound of roasted chestnuts. About 1 pound yields 1 cup. 2 sticks of unsalted butter softened, 1.5 cups of powdered sugar, 2 teaspoons of vanilla extract, 1/2 teaspoon of cinnamon, plus more for the garnish, 1/4 teaspoon of fresh nutmeg, 1/8 teaspoon of salt, and 2 cups of all-purpose flour sifted. Well, as you can see, these cookies have very few ingredients. We're going to start with 2 softened sticks of unsalted butter. Now, what I did prior to this is I used like my mini chopper and I got 1 cup of the chestnuts. It's about 1 pound. And I'm gonna add these to the bowl. Okay. And then what we'll do is mix these two together and start making the dough. And just combine the nuts with the butter. As you can see, it's just the nuts and the butter mixed together. You just want to cream them and make sure they're combined. And now we are going to add, 1/2 cup of powdered sugar, a little bit of salt, the vanilla, the cinnamon, and fresh grated nutmeg. You gotta be careful with the nutmeg because you really don't want too much because I think it adds a soapy flavor. Okay. And then we will mix this further. And now we begin adding the flour. So let me, and we'll do this, oh, about 1/4 cup at a time so you don't have the flour bomb. And I will just put this in the dough as we go. Now you don't have to, but I do recommend that you sift the flour. I think it makes for a lighter cookie. All right, so now our dough has assembled. It looks great. Then just split it right in half because you want the dough to remain as chilled as possible. And then what I'm gonna do, seal it up nice. And then refrigerate it for a few hours or overnight, a few days. But if you're not going to cook it after a few days, bake it rather. Just, you know, put it in the freezer till you're ready to use it. You want the dough to remain chilled. So only cook off 1 packet at a time. So I have this half out. And I'll tell you, this is nice and firm. And what we want is about 1-inch ball. They don't spread, so you don't have to worry about placement. You can put them all on the same tray. Make sure it's lined with parchment. And that is about 1 knuckle. My knuckle is about 1 inch. Yes, I use it for measurement. And then you just place it there. And you could go up to 1 inch apart because they do not spread. Well, this batch came out to be about 27 cookies. And I have them rolled nice and neatly in 1-inch balls. And I have the oven set at 350. I'm going to start watching them at 12 minutes. Well, I baked these cookies for actually 13 minutes. I did put 1 more minute on after the 12. And they're still light on top. And you just want them a little golden brown on the bottom. So they're pretty sturdy. So what I've done is let me do this really quick. I took the other cup of powdered sugar and then a half a teaspoon of the ground cinnamon, and you mix that up. So you just stick them up, and I just put them upside down and I roll them, see, in the dough. Isn't that nice? And it sticks nice because it's warm. And then I cool them on the rack. Now this is a beautiful cookie. Tastes delicious. Light, crumbly, loaded with flavor. Honestly, the chestnuts really add a different taste rather than walnuts, excuse me, or a pecan. All right, so that was something sweet with the chestnuts. Up next, the chestnut hummus. For this recipe, you'll need 1 cup of roasted chestnuts, 1/2 cup of tahini, 2 large garlic cloves chopped, 1/2 cup of water, juice from 1 lemon, 1/2 teaspoon of cumin, 1/4 teaspoon of cardamom, 1/4 cup of extra virgin olive oil, 1 to 2 tablespoons of plain Greek yogurt, and salt and pepper to taste. Now, I really like my tahini nice and smooth, and it takes a while to really blend it because of the nuts. So I suggest, if you have some big pieces, just kind of chop them up coarsely. And now I will add this to the bowl. We want the blade attachment, and we're just going to put all these ingredients into the bowl. Put the tahini in. Everything goes in right now except the salt, the pepper, and the Greek yogurt. You don't have to drizzle, and I'm just going to add 1/2 of the water that the recipe calls for. You can always add more, but it's harder to take out. So we'll put this on, and you don't even have to pulse it. You just go straight on. The Casey Malone Show will return with chestnut hummus and Philomena's cranberry salsa. All right, it's been about a solid minute. And as I look, it still is a little thick and a little chunky, if you can see that. So I am going to add the other 1/2 of this water. And I'm going to run this for about another minute or two because I really like it creamy. All right, I let this go a good 3 to 4 minutes because, you know, when you usually make hummus, it doesn't have like a nut product in it. Now we got to kick it up a notch. I think it needs a little salt. This is the time you adjust. And I'm just going to do not a lot of salt, maybe a teaspoon, and a couple grinds of black pepper. And then I'm going to share my little secret with you. I was at a Lebanese restaurant years ago in Toledo, and I had the hummus there. It was the best hummus I'd ever eaten. And I said to the guy, you know, my God, your hummus is so good. And he said, you know what the secret is? At the very end, add a teaspoon or so of Greek yogurt, just plain Greek yogurt. And ever since then, that's what I do. So that is my hot tip for today. So now I'll put that on, and we're just gonna blend this for a couple minutes, a couple seconds really. Beautiful presentation. All I did was give it a smear on the plate and then a little drizzle of extra virgin olive oil. And I saved some of the chestnuts and chopped those on top. And look at that creaminess. Ooh, it is so good. And I know I won't be disappointed. It is absolutely delicious. The chestnut with the tahini and the garlic, I mean, it really, really works. Well, as promised, we have a special guest for our final dish. And this is Philomena Roshoni's recipe.
Yes.
And you shared it with Anthony, and then Anthony shared it with me.
I'm glad
he
did.
It is fabulous. Cranberry salsa.
I thought you'd like it.
And I just think the flavors, I think the colors, it is just perfect for the holidays.
It's nice.
We don't get cranberries all year long.
We don't. And I did try to substitute with frozen or something, and it doesn't work, and it doesn't yield to freezing either. So enjoy it while the cranberries are fresh. So make the best of it. Yeah, live it up while the cranberries are fresh.
Now, you seriously. know, Philomena is the owner of Wedgwood Pizza. And I've got a couple questions before we go into the dish. Busiest day, would it be the Wednesday before Thanksgiving or Super Bowl?
Definitely Super Bowl, and second to that would be Halloween, which is really giving Super Bowl a run for the money when it falls on a weekday, Monday through Thursday, yes.
Okay, so the ingredients, we should go over the ingredient list and then we'll come back and we'll make it. For this recipe, you'll need 1 bag, 3 cups of fresh cranberries, 1 small red onion, 3 jalapeno peppers, de-seeded if you want less heat, 6 tablespoons of fresh cilantro chopped, 15 cherry or grape tomatoes chopped, 3/4 cup sugar or sugar substitute equivalent, 1 teaspoon of cumin, and 3 tablespoons of fresh lime juice. First thing we do, one at a time,
yeah.
Okay, the cranberries.
And I did try and do it all together, but it doesn't work, it gets too mushy. So you definitely want to do everything separate. Because the cranberries will take a little longer.
Okay, so.
And then you pulse them. I did try them at a coarser pulse, but I find it's better because the cranberries tart and bitter.
So you don't want them too chunky, right?
You don't want them. I can't see how yours
Let's
is.
See. Okay. How is that?
How do you like that? I think that maybe just a little smidge more.
Okay.
Just a little bit more. Yeah, too chunky because the bitterness is still a lot for a lot of people to take. Perfect, perfect.
Lovely.
Really nice, really nice. I'll let you put this on, Casey, because.
My gosh. You thought I knew what I was doing. Okay, so now the red onion. Now, you like red as opposed to
yes,
the sweet.
Definitely.
I think I like the bite.
Exactly, it needs it. It needs it. So again, you'll pulse this till. And like I said, it really does have to be done only step by step because otherwise it does get too mushy.
Yeah. So now, we like the heat, so I did not deseed these. But if you don't like heat, you could probably just not even use them or use a bell.
Okay.
All right. So is there any particular order?
No. Just finish the tomatoes then. Put the tomatoes. I just add the liquid.
These so they don't get too soupy.
The juice. Go ahead, the juice. And then the sugar and the cumin and then the cilantro at last. I put that at the last after we mix it a bit.
Then the sugar.
And like, you know, it, once it gets
Because
liquid.
You do need that sugar because it is bitter.
Bitter. It's tart. Tart is very, very tart. Yeah.
And you want the cumin.
And
then,
beautiful.
Oh, look at all that gorgeous fresh cilantro. Mmm. Love it.
It's really nice.
Well, join me in a little
toast. Definitely.
Now this is this Dubon Brut Reserve. It is a cava from Spain. I love it. We'll just drop some pomegranate seeds in. Isn't that fun? I am a huge fan.
I mean, it's so fresh.
It is delicious. Mmm. All right.
Delicious.
As my mother says, here's to us, none better.
You got that right.
There you go.
Thank you.
Cheers.
Thank you.
Mm.
Oh, is that nice?
Really
cleanses
the palate. So, you want Philomena's recipe? Just go to my website, CaseyMaloneShow.com, and look for the cranberry salsa. Cheers again.
Cheers.
Thank you so much.
You're welcome. Thank you, Casey.